Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.
Hello and welcome to the curtain raiser to our 8th edition of the CNBC TV18 UTI Mutual Fund Financial Advisor Awards. For the past 8 years, both of us, CNBC TV18 and UTI Mutual Fund, have been galvanizing the financial advisor community to propel itself to higher and higher standards of excellence. The last year, we had 38,000 nominations for this awards. And the jury has a hard time trying to pick regional awards as well as national award winners for their contribution to educating their community, the way they serve the investor community, and the way they improve their standards of service and of communication.
Recognizing the critical role that financial advisors play in the wealth preservation process and the power of sound advice, UTI Mutual Fund and CNBC TV18 celebrates the effort of financial advisors across the country. Over the years, the Financial Advisor Awards continue to honor the best financial advisors who have set benchmarks in the industry by maximizing investors' returns through sound advice in the highly volatile market. This year, we kickstart the 8th UTI Mutual Fund and CNBC TV18 Financial Advisor Awards with a power-packed interaction between Lata Venkatesh, the Executive Editor of CNBC TV18 and the MD of UTI Asset Management Company, Leo Puri.
Can you begin by highlighting to me how you understand the role of the financial advisor? Clearly, 2016 has taught us that change is the only constant. In terms of finance, we are being buffeted by more and more unexpected news. So how does that change the role of the financial advisor according to you?
It continues to strengthen the necessity of such a profession. And indeed, it is becoming a profession. Even more so in times of uncertainty, the need for the balance, the rationality, the ability to step back becomes important. The ability to contemplate longer-term issues and balance between consumption and savings, intergenerational savings, retirement. These are issues that become perhaps even more pressing at this point. So I think it's very timely that we are hosting this, the 8th edition.
Okay. Well, the 8th edition also comes on the heels of the demonetization, which whose positive avatar is really digitization of the economy. I mean, per force, we are seeing people accepting non-cash payments, either plastic or digital movement of money. How does that change the role of the mutual fund industry itself? Do you see yourself getting more customers?
Yes, I think we have virtually doubled. The industry has virtually doubled in the last 3 years at 16 lakh crores, from 7 to 8 lakh crores. So let's not forget the very good news on which we are riding. We'll come to some of the concerns later, I'm sure. But right now, the good news is we've more or less doubled. Clearly, that has represented an opportunity for professionals in the industry. Demonetization is fundamentally good for financial inclusion. As you say, digitization is a way to catalyze people's participation in the formal economy, and a large part of that will eventually find its way into our industry, into both debt and equity products, balanced products as well. So this should be seized upon as a chance to say the number of investors is going to expand dramatically, both because of our demographics, but now because of this catalyst. And therefore, the volume of money that our sector is going to have to absorb and deploy is also going to go up in a non-linear way over the next 2 or 3 years. It's a very welcome opportunity for us and should bring some cheer, New Year cheer, to our advisors.
Okay. Before I come to the advisors, sir, this digitization and expansion of financial inclusion in the real sense of the term also brings with it challenges, doesn't it?
The great Indian middle class, yes, which numbers anywhere between 150 to 400 million people, depending, yes, on who is measuring it. That is the belly of our financial system. They are not participating actively at this point in our industry. It's still somewhat dominated by institutions on the debt side and HNIs, you know, on equity in terms of the lumpy flows. So it's not a matter of virtue. It's a matter of economic necessity for us, if we wish to grow, to actively engage with this segment. Fortunately for us, digitization is lowering the cost of acquisition and the cost of servicing. Fortunately for us, regulation is making it easier in terms of onboarding through Aadhaar-based KYC and overcoming some of the operating restrictions that we face. So with these tailwinds, we have less and less excuse not to go out and embrace this segment. It's a really, really good time to be in our industry right now.
How do you see digitization in the mutual fund sector itself? Are you all end-to-end eKYC to e-payments to, you know, electronically reaching out payments? Can it be done really facelessly?
Our view is, if a person has come on board, let's say with a bank, and been declared compliant, we should simply be able to take that and move on instead of getting them to redo their KYC. The insurance industry, I'm told, does this. Mm. At this point, you need to still do a separate KYC for the mutual fund industry. And I think to any lay observer, that would immediately raise a question, why? If a bank has done so, why do we need to? And the bank by now, thanks to Jan Dhan, has done a KYC on
practically
on almost everyone, we are told. So I think that I would use this as an appeal to say, let's just close that last mile. That will really help us push forward. And I think our own regulator, SEBI, is very supportive of this. It needs a little bit of help from the Ministry of Finance. So operationally, that is the bottleneck we need to overcome for onboarding and so on. Then it's up to us to make the investments in servicing. Our industry is still viewed as a little complicated. Why do one of the reasons people like a bank account is it's now viewed as quite simple. We need to replicate that level of confidence and simplicity as opposed to being viewed as a bit of a black box. They need to believe that they can get their money out as easily as they can put it in. I think next year you will see many of us taking that issue up more seriously, which is repositioning ourselves as a much easier platform that will facilitate transactions on par with the standards people have come to accept from the other parts of the financial system, in particular banks.
Well, Mr. Puri, hold on to that thought. We need to take a break. We are back with more questions for Mr. Puri about financial advisors and where they are in the process of evolution.